name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, brothers and sisters, we begin, I guess what the Western Church would say, ordinary time. We're into our Gospel of Matthew. And we're going to read through the Gospel of Matthew all through the summer and into fall, until we get to September after the Feast of the Exaltation of the Cross. And in today's Gospel, we hear the calling of the disciples. This is Matthew's version of Christ choosing his disciples to come and follow him. This is presented in the Gospels, depending on which Gospel we read, in different formats. It would seem odd that just a strange man would come up to these fishermen, Peter, James, and John, and say, "Follow me," and they would run and leave their livelihood behind and leave their family behind. And so we have to understand that some of the disciples, they all knew each other. Some of them were disciples of John the Baptist, who was paving the way for the Lord to come. So they had already understood. They were waiting for the Messiah. These were very religious and devoted individuals. So when Christ did appear, they were convicted in their heart to do just that, to leave their livelihood behind, to leave their family, and to follow him. And so we're supposed to come out of this Gospel text in a way that we too want to follow Christ. We want to leave behind those things which hold us down to the earth and become like angels, his disciples, and follow him. And it's a lot easier said than done. Many of us here say we believe in God, right? We believe in Christ. We're members of his church. But to believe in Christ and to follow him are two different things. To believe and to say on your lips that you believe in Christ is an easy task. Most of us were raised in the faith. So it's an easy thing to say, "Yeah, I'm a believer. I believe." It's a whole other thing to say, "I follow. I follow Christ." Because what does following Christ entail? It means a little bit of sacrifice on our end, on our part. As evident in the Gospel today, these fishermen left the only way they knew how to make a living. Left it immediately. All the boats, the nets, everything, all their possessions were left. We hear about John and James and the sons of Zebedee, their father. They left his father right there and left to follow Christ. And so we have to be willing to leave behind. We heard the Gospel last week for All Saints that the disciples do indeed ask Christ, "Well, we left our family, we left our livelihood, we left everything. What shall we inherit for this?" And he says, "In the kingdom of heaven, you'll get a hundredfold for making the sacrifice now." And so we have to look at ourselves and say, how are we following Christ? In what way are we sacrificing him? Do we sacrificing for him? Or do we just believe in him with our lips? If we were to, and we celebrate all the saints of Russia today, the majority of the saints in the vast history of Russia came in the last century under persecution from the Soviet government, the Bolsheviks. A lot of martyrs, and we have a special Sunday in our church for them. But that's the majority of the saints. And they were put to death often because they were followers of Christ. And they were convicted of it, and they were persecuted, and the government had to show them, "Yes, we have proof that you were a follower of Christ." They used to have to hide all their belongings of Christ in their home. They had to pray in secret. And so the government would have to go and say, have a trial, and put these people on trial. They were unfair trials, but they were trials nonetheless. And so if you put yourselves in their shoes today, here in America, if you were put on trial for being a follower of Christ, for following him, would there be enough evidence to convict you? Could you be convicted of being a follower of Christ? So could they go into your life and see, "Oh, you're such a follower of Christ. I see you go to church this often. You're praying every day. You wear your cross. You make the sign of the cross over your meal. You reach out to people. You're kind. You're doing all those things we heard today, the Beatitudes. You're living the life of Christ." Would you be convicted of it? Could you be? Or would it just be something that would be difficult to find evidence? Maybe you were just a cat. Maybe you have a couple things, icons in your home that are have some dust on them, a prayer book with some dust. You can just say circumstantially, you have some things, but we don't know if you're a true follower. So we have to look at ourselves. Would we be convicted of being a follower of Christ if someone from the outside came and looked at our lives? There's an old saying, if you are who you hang out with, if you looked at your bank account, we can tell kind of who the person you are, right? You are what you eat and how you act, right? You've heard all these sayings, these analogies, and it's very true. If you looked at your life,